Hi friends, welcome to yet another video of Indian Financial Service. Today in this video we are going to discuss about another concept of Indian Financial Service, that is a concept of securitization. Let us see, securitization is the process of conversion of existing asset or future cash flow into marketable securities. In other words, securitization deals with conversion of assets which are not marketable into marketable ones. Securitization, the practice of pooling together of various types of debt instruments such as mortgages and other consumer loans and selling them as bonds to investors. A bond complied in this way is generally referred to as asset-backed security or ABS, or it is otherwise called collateralized debt obligation or CDO. If the pool of debt instruments consists primarily of mortgages, the bond is referred to as a mortgage-backed security or MBS. The holders of such securities are entitled to the receipt of principal and interest payment on the debt underlying them. Securitization is the method of converting the receivables of financial institutions, that is loans and advances, into bonds which are then sold to investors. This is the process of converting your receivables of the financial institutions, that is loans or advances, you are converting into bonds, then selling into the market situation. In simple terms, securitization is the means of turning the liquid assets into liquid asset, illiquid assets into liquid assets. So the process of turning the illiquid assets into liquid assets to free up the blocked capital. So this is the meaning of securitization process. Securitization is the process of converting the receivables of the financial institutions, that is you are converting your loans and advances into bonds which they are sold into the concerned investors, or it is the means of turning the illiquid assets into liquid assets to free up the blocked capital, to free up the block capital process. Securitized debt instruments are financial securities that are created by securitizing individual loans, or it is a debt. It is a financial process that involves issuing securities that are backed by a number of assets. Most commonly, it is a debt. The assets are transferred into securities and the process is called securitization. The owner of the securities receives an income from underlying assets. Hence the term asset-backed securities. So why it is called asset-backed securities? The owner of the securities receives an income from this underlying securities. Hence we can use the term as asset-backed securities. Let us see what is the securitization process. Securitization is a complex and lengthy process, since it is the conversion of receivables into bonds and it involves multiple parties. The steps involved in the process of securitization are, we discussed in the next part. In the first step, that is called obligation function. The borrower approaches a banks or the financial institution or the organizer for a loan. The respective financial institution allows certain sum as debt in exchange of in exchange for any collateral. So this is a process of a organization function. So after organization function, the next function is the pooling function. In pooling function, the organizer then sells off its receivables through pledge receipt to the special purpose vehicle. So this is the process of pooling. So selling off its receivable through pledge receipt to the special purpose vehicle, that is in the in case of a pooling function. And third one is the securitization process. The SPV transforms these receivables into marketable securities, that is either through pay through certificate or PTC or pass through certificate. So PTC, pay through certificate or pass through certificate. These instruments then forwarded to the merchant banks for selling it into investors. The investors buy these instruments to benefit in the long run process. So here in this part we discussed two important terms, SPV and PTC. So I'll tell you what is these two terms. First one is SPV, is special purpose vehicle. It is created to carry out a specific business purpose or activity. SPVs are frequently used in structured finance transactions such as asset securitizations, joint ventures, or into isolate certain company assets or operations. So this is the object of special purpose vehicle or SPV. And the second term, PTC, that is pass through certificate, is a certificate that is given to an investor against certain mortgaged blocked securities that lies with the issuer. Securitization involves the conversion of these incomes or receivables into debt instruments, which are then sold to investors. So PTC is a certificate that is given to an investor against certain mortgage backed securities that lies with the issuer. So that is the concept of a PTC. Let us see what are the different types of securitization process. Different types or kinds of receivables determine the types of securitization in its requirements. And I will tell you some of the important types of securitization process. And the first one is called asset-backed securities or ABS. The bonds which are supported by underlying financial assets, the receivables which are converted into ABS include credit card debt, student loans, home equity loans, auto loans, etc. So there will be a process of converting ABS, asset backed securities, like the debt in the credit card, the debt of student loan, there will be some sort of auto loans or home equity loans that you can convert into security, that is ABS, asset backed securities. And second one is residential mortgage backed securities or MBS, residential mortgage backed securities or mortgage backed securities. These mortgages comprises of, there are some bonds, and these bonds comprises of some mortgages like property, land, house, jewelry, and any other valuables that will be comes under MBS, that is mortgage backed securities. So it may be either residential things like land, property, asset, jewelry, or any other valuables that will be comes into the bond that mortgage bond category of residential mortgage backed securities. Then the third one is commercial mortgage backed securities, that is CMBS. So the bonds that are formed by building different commercial asset mortgages such as office building, industrial land, plant, factory, etc., that will be comes in under the category of commercial mortgage backed securities. So here there will be formed by that is a bond that is formed by building, that will be different commercial assets. It will be the part of CMBS, that is commercial mortgage backed securities. So the fourth one is collateralized debt obligation or CDO. CDO are the bonds designed by rebuilding the personal debt to the marketed in the security market for purposive investors. So CDO are the bonds that is designed by the rebuilding the personal debt to the marketed in the security market for prospective investors. So they are looking for the prospective investors in cases of a CDO. Let us see what are the types of advantages. What are the different types of advantages? What are the advantages of securitization to the two parties? Two categories are there, and first category we are discussing here, that is from the part of originator. What are the advantages of a securitization? So in cases of originator, the first advantages is unblocked capital. Through the securitization process, the originator can recover the amount lent much earlier than the prescribed period. So there will be the recovering process of the amount that he actually lent, and he can recover the amount much earlier than the prescribed time period. And another one is provides liquidity. The liquid assets such as the receivables on loans sanctioned by bank are converted into liquid assets. And the third one is lowers funding cost. With the help of securitization, even the BB grade companies can benefit availing the benefit of AA rates if it has and AA rates cash flow. So B category companies are getting some sort of benefits of A category companies, because those who are making profit, those who are getting profit, these who are not getting profit last few years. So the financial positions of that companies are that they are facing some sort of financial problems. Even that type of companies, they are getting financial assistance just like what this type of A category companies they are getting. Then the risk management process, the financial institutions lending the funds can transfer the risk of bad debts by securitizing its receivables. So that is the next advantage. And another one is overcoming profit uncertainty. There will be some sort of profit uncertainty when there will be the recovery of bad debts is uncertain. Is profitability in the long run? It is equally doubtful. That's securitization of such obligation is suitable option to avoid unwanted losses. Then reduces the need for financial leverage. Securitization releases the blocked capital to maintain liquidity. Therefore, the originator need not seek to financial leverage in cases of any immediate requirement. And from the part of investor, that is the second part, some of the advantages are there will be a quality investment process. The purchase of MBS and ABS are considered to be a wise investment option due to their feasibility and reliability. So that is the first important advantages from the part of an investor. And the second one is less credit risk. The securitized assets have higher credit worthiness. So that is why it is these are treated separately from their parent entity. So that is the another advantages of securitization from the part of a investor. Then the third one is there will be a better return. Securitization is a means of making a superior return on their investment. However, it depends more on the investor's risk-taking ability. So that is the third one. And the fourth one, there will be a diversified portfolio strategy will be there. The investor can attain a well-diversified portfolio on including the securitized bonds. So since there are very different, these are very different from other instruments, so you can go for a diversified portfolio strategies on including the securitized bonds, since these are very different from other types of instruments. So that is why a diversified portfolio strategy that will get through this securitization process. And another one is benefit to the small investors. The investors having minimal capital for investment can also take a profit out of securitized bonds. So this is the another advantages of securitization process. We have discussed two areas advantages, and let us see what are the limitations of securitization process. And the first one is a lack of transparency. SPV may not be disclosed the complete information about the asset included in the securitized bond to the investors. So that is why there will be a lack of transparency. And it is a complex to handle situation. The whole process of securitization is quite complicated, involving there will be multiple parties engaged into it, and also these assets need to be blended wisely. So there will be a blending, you're mixing a lot of things, and there will be a complex handling process. So that is why it is very difficult to handle the process of securitization. And the another one is the investor bears risk process. So from the part of investor, there will be high risk process. Non-repayment of debt by the borrower would ultimately end up as the loss for the investors. Therefore, the investor is the sole risk bearer in this securitization process. And next one is it is a quite expensive one. When compared to share flotation, the cost of securitized bond is usually high. You have to spend high cost for the securitization process, including there will be underwriting process, legal formalities, administration, and other rating charges for the securitization process. Then the next one is inaccurate risk management. So there will be a difficulty in the risk management process, and it is not always true. Sometimes even the originator fails to identify the value of underlying assets or the associated credit risk in that particular investment. Another one is a loss from repayment. If the borrower pays off some earlier than the defined time period, the investor will not take much superior gains on their investment value. So normally they are paying an earlier time than the defined period, that the return for the investor is comparatively very low. So these are the discussions in this video regarding the securitization part. And thank you all for watching in this video of financial service, and see you in the next video. And thank you all. See you.